Amen.
All right. We're going to go on to another scripture in regards to following the Son, the theme here, and that would be in John 14:6. The good news from God's Word says this. Jesus said to him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father but through me. And I just want to encourage you, there's a lot of false religions out in the world right now. And I'll tell you what, there's only one way to the Father, and that is through His Son. His Son was the sacrificial lamb that took the sins of the world. And we have free access to come up unto the throne of God and boldly ask anything that we desire, and it will be done for us as we come through the Son of the living God, and that's Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ. There's a lot of false religions that try to shortcut the way to God. But I'll tell you right now, Buddha's not going to save you. Muhammad won't save you. There is no false religion that will save you, but only the sacrificial lamb that came, and that's Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. Amen. When you have Jesus, you have access to come to the Father. How exciting that God the Father will look upon you as a child. Only if you've come through the Son. Amen? That's an important part to remember, because we want to make sure that we're accurate, we're lining up our faith to the Word of God. And there's a paraphrase that kind of encourages us along this line. As the way, Jesus is the path of the Father. As the truth, He is the reality of all God's promises. And as the life, He joins His divine life to ours, both now and in eternity. So that's good news from God's Word. Not only will you have a better life while you're down here because you're letting Him hold your hand and you're walking through this life with Jesus, but then the good news is that you have your reservation in for heaven, which will be a place you'll be for a long time. So make sure you got those reservations in. Make sure you've got your peace with God, because when He comes back, there might not be time for another quick, oh, but Lord, I was going to get with You, and oh, hold up, what were we supposed to do now? Call upon the name of the Lord. No, call upon Him while it is still yet a day. Today is the day of salvation. Harden not your heart. There's some people say, well, I was going to get with Jesus back in 1987, and then I went to this party and started hanging out. You know, you wait too long, you might not ever make it back.
That's right.
And then young people say sometimes, well, you know, I just got to get out here and see life a little. I understand what you're saying about this Jesus. He is the way, the truth, and the life, but I got to make sure there's some things out here I can... You know, I don't want to miss what the world has. But I'm telling you right now, Satan is the god of this world, and all you have out there is to rob, kill, and destroy. That's what will happen to your life. Why take the bait of Satan when Jesus said, I came to give you life and give it to you to the fullest? Amen? Good news from God's Word. We're going to go to Matthew 11:28. Some of you are following along. And this scripture is Matthew 11:28. And 30. It says, come unto me, all you who are weary and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. That's good news right there. If you're tired, man, who needs some rest today? Anybody? And you know, we might not be physically tired, but we might just be sick and tired of being sick and tired. We're trying so hard, and sometimes we work too hard at life. God has never intended for us to take too much load and burden upon ourselves. He says, come unto me, all you who are weary and heavy laden, I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle, this is Jesus talking, and humble in heart. And you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. See, a lot of people carry too much of the cares of this world on their shoulders. And the Bible says we're actually to cast all of our cares upon the Lord, because He never intended for us to carry any more than what we can bear. And the paraphrase on this talks about a yoke with oxen. I think this would be a good analogy for you to see the importance. It says a yoke is a heavy wooden harness that fits over the shoulders of an oxen or an ox. It is attached to a piece of equipment and the oxen are to pull. A person may be carrying heavy burdens of number one, sin. Number two, excessive demands. Number three, oppression and depression and persecution, weariness in their search for God. Jesus frees people from all of these burdens. The rest that Jesus promises is love, healing, peace with God, not the end of all labor. A relationship with God changes meaningless, wearisome toil into spiritually productive productivity and purpose. So even the very meager things that you do day in and day out, cleaning your house, doing the laundry, going to work, washing your car, all those things can be spiritual celebrations to God, having an attitude of gratitude and not worrying about all the cares of this world. I always tell people, you're either going to be overcome by the cares of this world or you'll be able to overcome through the blood of the Lamb and through the word of your testimony. You'll be able to put the devil in his place and say, devil, why are you trying to load me down with all this? I don't know how I'm going to make all these ends meet, but I know that God will supply all my needs according to his riches and glory. Devil, put him in his place and tell him to get back and get off. You ain't got time to carry all that pressure. Amen? Amen. I always tell people, you're going to have enough trials and tribulations just naturally in this life as a believer. Amen? Amen. So why would you want to load on yourself more than what God himself is expecting? So that's good news from God's word. He says, if you are feeling a little overwhelmed, because right now with the economy, the job situation, there was a couple people in our food line on Tuesday, brand new people that lost jobs and they're staying at the shelter. This man said, I never thought I'd sleep in a shelter. He was working construction, lost his job. But you know, whether it's a new thing or you've been struggling a long time, the good news is God wants to give you rest. But you have to give up all of that trying so hard. The Bible says there's a way that seems right to man, but the end thereof is death. Don't do what seems right in your own eyes, because you're going to mess it up. Every day you got to look at a new fresh day, a fresh beginning. Don't worry about yesterday's sins. They're covered by the blood. And why sweat about tomorrow? Tomorrow's not even promised to you. You only have today is the day that the Lord has made. So rejoice and be thankful. Look at your life more as what you do have, not just all the things you don't have. Because if you keep dwelling on that, that will bring that negativity and that burden of how can I work a second job to have that better car or how can I do this? No. The Bible says to seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. Everything else you need will be added. That's a promise, yes and amen, from the word of God.
Praise the Lord.
And in the meantime, be thankful for the car you have. Wash it up, clean it out, spray it up a little bit, and just see if God, being a good God as he is, will bless you with something more. But if you're not thankful with what you have, you're going to burden yourself down. And like I say, you'll lose the rest, that peace and rest that God wants to give you. Even in the midst of your storm, when you don't have hardly anything to work with, you can still have peace in the midst of a storm. The peace of God will give you that peace. Amen? That's good news from God's word. Okay, let's move along. Amen. Someone's excited? Woo! Might as well get excited. All right, we're going to go on now, move along. John 6:44, if you're following along. If not, there's always good news from the word of God. And again, we're talking about following the Son. And that's the most important thing you can do in your life, is to follow the Son, Jesus Christ. No one can come to me unless the Father who sent me draws him, and I will raise him up on the last day.